By the 42nd amendment to the constitution in 1976, forests were brought to the concurrent list in the 7th schedule. This has enabled central government to play an effective role. What is the concurrent list is that both state as well as the center have an effective role in the management of forests, and it was done by the President of India, promulgated the Forest Conservation Ordinance, which put severe restrictions on de-reservation of forests or use of forest land for non-forestry purposes without the approval of the central government. Now, there are some peculiar features of the forest. Taking forest as a business enterprise and taking any other normal business enterprise, unlike agriculture enterprise or any other manufacturing unit, forestry is based on a long investment. Agriculture crops are annual, or any other product we are producing in the factories, those are produced in a very small amount of time, unlike forestry, which is to be invested for a long term, say 10 years, 15 years or more than that. The second is the identity of the product and the manufacturing plant. Now, we know the manufacturing plant is separate and the product is separate. Both can be separated in terms of normal business enterprise, whereas in forestry, the trees are the manufacturing unit, and the increment which we get on the trees is the product. That means the manufacturing plant and the product that we get from it are inseparable. Both are the same. So it is sometimes it becomes difficult to separate the product on a short term basis from the manufacturing plant. Number three is the multiple and varied land use. We know that forests provide us timber. They may provide us with minor forest produce. In addition to that, they have these forests have different uses, including climatic amelioration, soil amelioration, biodiversity, providing oxygen, providing a house to glaciers, snow, which form the source of perennial water, and many other things. So it doesn't have any one or single use, but have a multiple use. Now, another peculiar feature of forest as an enterprise is that these are placed at the locations which are less accessible and less fertile. So the forest enterprise requires long-term investment executed through a written document known as working plan. What is a working plan? A working plan is a written scheme of management aiming at continuity of policy controlling the treatment of a forest. So that's all about introduction to forest management.